Welcome to Pocket Woman Lock Picking and Lock Sport. In the vise is a Lockwood 120N 50mm. It has no shackle, well, it's a cut shackle. And it's pretty cruddy. And I'm going to try and pick one of the 120/110 range for the first time. I have given this a go yesterday for about an hour, two separate sessions, 30 minutes each, and got nowhere with it. Just kept getting into a false set, and that was it. So let's see what we can do. Fresh eyes today. Let's start off with the diamond, see how we go with that. Is this keyway not easy? This piece of wood in here is totally in the way. Trying to look for a binder. This is possibly a six pinner, not sure. It's pretty crunchy in there. Oh wow, big false set. And that's where I've been getting to. So from there, it should only be, you know, a matter of one pin, but it's not. It seems like pin one's binding. Just can't get under it. And some little nudges, better count on two. So these should be full of spools, possibly five spools, one standard. And this is where I get to and get stuck. Where is that last pin? Jiggle test. See if the springs are still engaged. Little nudges. I'd be so stoked if I got this. I've never been able to pick anything in the 120 range. I think I picked a little one, maybe a 25mm one. Oh, I'll do full set. Everything feels so scratchy and grabby. Nothing's running smooth in the chambers. Really difficult to find out what's going on. I'm feel for what's bouncing up, what's not. They all feel okay, except the ones at the back. It's very grabby, so you can feel that. See, this could have had a cut shackle because the tummy failed on the inside of the lock. So I could be just trying to pick a broken lock. Don't know. Just got this from Salvage Yard. It's so grubby. Just trying to feel what the pins are doing. Who's springy, who's binding, who's overset. Got no idea. Again, and then the bit can stop. So that's what I've been getting to. stuck. Full set. Paper faucet. Give everything a little nudge. That's super light tension. Someone's put graphite on it at some stage. Might try. Give it a little bit of a reiki kind of thing. tension anyway. Let's see what happens. Just bounce them pins. Oh, a deeper faucet. Let's see if I can get any binders. Okay, well, there's definitely some binding in the middle of the lock. There's definitely a pin stuck there. Let's see if that's good. It's binding a bit. Whoa, yes. Ha-ha. Wow. Wow, that took some getting. Totally took some getting. Okay, so that is open. Yes. Wow, so cool. So cool to get this. So that's your cut shackle. Shackle released. Open state. It's quite a return spring on that. Feeling that now. Oh, so happy to get that. All right. Very nice. Lock that back up. Put that back in. Very nice. So the thing about the Lockwood 120N, all the 120Ns, so they've got this jacket on, but when you take the skirt off, they've got nothing on the brass body to say that it's a Lockwood, whereas the original stuff, the 120s, have all got this logo embossed into the body of the lock. So that's the same. So if you lose this, this comes off, you wouldn't even know it was a Lockwood, which is a real shame. Anyway, that's the 120N/50. So I might strip this off, try and get all the pins out, the core out, and have a look and see what's inside on the part two of the 120N/50. Thanks for watching. Stay legal. Temptation is everywhere.